Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Real Life. I hope you're having a great day. It's always a pleasure to share a new episode with you. Before we start today's episode, a reminder that you have access to our easy-to-use episode map guide, which will link you to all 1,300-plus episodes around the globe. Just click on the map link below, zoom into any part of the planet, click on the blue, red, or orange dot to connect you directly with that episode. The episode title and details will appear on the left side. Click on the blue link, and you're on to that vintage reel or video. You may want to zoom in closer, as there may be more than one episode clustered together. This episode is a proper and intriguing mystery. The film can was unmarked, and a single scrap of paper was found inside marked Uvera. That suggests the name of the sailboat. I'll apologize in advance, as I'm not a sailor, so I find myself at a disadvantage trying to identify all that is going on in this remarkable reel. The film is a mix of 1933 and 34 Kodak stock. Try as I might, I found very few online references to a Uvera sailboat of any significance. However, there are a few small clues to help identify some of the locations. The background features, harbors, other ships, and architecture are clues in of themselves. A small vessel at 11 minutes 26 indicates New York. At about 14 minutes, some rather dramatic footage indicates a spar was broken and a mainsail is clearly badly damaged as the crew are making their way home. A little later, U.S. Navy sailors are on the deck at work. Is this a U.S. Navy vessel? Is this another vessel? At the 15-minute mark, several ships may be identified by someone familiar with 1930s East Coast maritime life, including a Texaco-marked small ship. A few minutes later, the neon sign of Rausch Cold Storage Warehouse on the waterfront indicates we're in Norfolk, Virginia. Don't forget to subscribe, as that's the only way you'll learn of the new episodes being released Fridays and Saturdays. Thank you for helping fill in the blanks on all these episodes. On occasions, I do make mistakes. I mispronounce locations and sometimes overlook some details. I very much appreciate the corrections you share on the comments section. Thanks for not being too hard on me. It's a delight seeing the collaboration among viewers. It's even more meaningful when I learn that a family member or friend is recognized, even 50-plus years later. The cinematographer captured some wonderful details: men climbing ladders, painting, welding, and navigating. The 1930s was nearing the end of an era. Schooners and tall ships were quickly being replaced by steamships. The Second World War would speed up the changes dramatically. When recreational travel returned in the early 1950s, the tall ships would be far less common, replaced increasingly by diesel-powered ocean liners. This reel is a reminder of a different time. There are many faces captured in clear detail. Given all the details captured and excellent camera work, I get the sense this may have been an important sailboat. There's likely much more to this footage than I may be aware of. I look forward to learning more about this ship. Enjoy. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Be kind, and we'll see you next time on Real Life.